Algebra 1 Summer School, Unit 3, Lesson 3, Notes Video. This is the features of graphs, notes, and what we're going to talk about today are different features of graphs. X and Y intercepts, increasing, decreasing, domain and range, that kind of thing. All right, so let's start with some of the easy features of graphs. We have X intercepts and Y intercepts. All right, an X intercept is a point or points where the graph crosses or touches the x-axis, okay? So when I look at this graph, I have to find the point or the points where the graph crosses or touches the x-axis. It appears to have an x-intercept at these two values. Now those were not at perfect, -4 and +5, so we're gonna estimate that that x-intercept there looks like it was at about -4.50, and maybe 5.250. We're just estimating, but we need to get the idea that the x-intercepts are where you cross or touch the x-axis. All right, same idea here with the y-intercept. This is the point where the graph crosses the y-axis. Okay, for a function, this will only happen once, and it appears to be this point right here where I cross the y-axis. Remember, the y-axis goes up and down, and that point appears to be at 0, 3. All right, so the x and y-intercepts are features of our graph that are really important for us. Next, excuse me, we have the maximum of a function and minimums of a function. The definition of a maximum is the highest point a graph has. So the highest point a graph has. Now when I look at this graph to the right, it appears that the very highest point is up here, and that ordered pair appears to be at -2, 6. When I ask you for a maximum, you need to write it as an ordered pair. Now the minimum of a function is the lowest point a graph has. So the very lowest point this graph has appears to be down here. And that ordered pair is at -4, -3. So we're going to be asking you for maximums and minimums in this lesson. All right, another feature of graphs are where my graph is increasing and decreasing. So increasing is an interval where the graph is going up from left to right. So where the graph goes up from left to right. All right, so when I look at my graph, I'm gonna read it just like I'm reading the book, a book. I'm gonna start on the left, and the first time it appears that my graph is going up is at this bottom point here, and it appears to go up until that point at the very top. Now, when I talk about values where I'm increasing and decreasing, it's really important that we need to look at the x values of the points. Okay, you're increasing and decreasing where between different x values. So it appears right here that this x value is -1, and you're increasing on all of these x values until you get to x of 3. So your graph is increasing between -1 and 3. That's what that inequality is telling you. Now, the definition of decreasing is very similar. It's an interval where the graph is going down from left to right. Now when I look at this graph, it looks like there's two spots where it goes down from left to right. Looks like this endpoint here to the bottom. So that x value that I start at here is -4. And I'm going down, 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 down until I get to the x value of -1. Because then from negative 1 all the way up to here, I'm increasing until I get to 3. And then from 3 to the x value of 6, I'm decreasing. Now this is a little bit harder of a concept, but we're going to format it kind of like these fill in the blank problems here. So you really only have to focus on identifying the x values between which you're increasing or decreasing. All right, 2 more features here. We have the axis of symmetry. Okay. Now, when I look at the axis of symmetry, a graph has an axis of symmetry if there's an invisible line that the graph reflects over. Symmetric about that line, then we say the graph has an axis of symmetry. So if I look at this first example, it kind of looks like there's an invisible line going through the parabola right in the middle there, that if I folded the graph over that line, it would look equal on both sides. So yes, this graph has an axis of symmetry. If I look at the next graph, it also appears that there's a line that goes right down the middle. And if I were to fold that graph over itself, then it would be symmetric. So yes, that graph also has an axis of symmetry. But finally, this third graph does not appear to have an axis of symmetry. There's no line that I can draw where it looks equal on both sides. So no, there's no axis of symmetry here. Hey, we're gonna go through a lot of examples here now of just identifying different features of graphs. So, in example 1, I have what we call a parabola. We want to know, first of all, is this graph a function? Well, if I'm looking at a graph to determine if it's a function, I have to decide if it passes the vertical line test. It appears that, yes, this graph would pass the vertical line test, so it is definitely a function. All right, so we're trying to figure out now where the graph is decreasing. So I look at my graph, and it looks like it's going down on this left-hand portion. Now this one's a little tricky. We have to be careful, but a lot of graphs are like this, so we're going to jump right into hard stuff. If I look at the end of this graph here, there's an arrow. And when I have an arrow, that implies that the graph is going on forever. When the graph is going on forever to the left this way, you're heading towards what we call negative infinity. So my graph starts decreasing at negative infinity, really far, small numbers. And it is decreasing until it gets to this x value that looks to be at 1/2. Okay. Then at 1/2, it appears that my graph starts increasing. So my graph starts increasing from 1/2, and notice there's another arrow. It increases forever. And if I go forever to the right, I get to infinity. So my graph is decreasing from the left forever until positive 1/2. Then once I get to 1/2, it starts going up forever and ever and ever. Now let's identify some x-intercepts here. Okay, when I look at this graph, I'm trying to find where I cross the x-axis. Okay, so the x-intercepts appear to be at those 2 points. The first point looks to be at negative 1, 0, and the other x-intercept is at 2, 0. Now I need to find the y-intercept. The y-intercept is where you cross the y-axis. That's that point right there, which appears to be at negative 2. You always say the x value first when you write an ordered pair. Now in this lesson, we're going to review function notation. So we're going to start by evaluating f of 1. That 1 is an x value. So I go into my graph where x equals 1, and I find my way down to the graph here. And I notice that at that x value of 1, my graph seems to have an output of negative 2. So f of 1 equals negative 2, and that gives me the ordered pair on the graph of 1, negative 2. Now, this time, I'm going to look for maximum and minimum values. When I look at my graph to try to find a maximum, on this graph, because there are arrows, that means the graph goes up forever. Because my graph goes up forever, there is just not one highest value. There's actually no maximum here because the graph goes up forever. But there is a very lowest point. This appears to be the very lowest point here on my graph. Now the scale's a little goofy, so we have to be a little bit careful here, but that appears to be at 1/2 and then -2.25. Usually we'll give you nice scales here, but this picture goes by quarters. Okay, so that is your minimum value. Now the last thing we have is domain and range. Now we didn't talk about this on the original features of graphs, but domain here deals with the x values of the graph. The x values are always looking left to right. Okay, so when I'm trying to find the domain, I'm going to start at the very left of my graph. How far does my graph go to the left? Well, if I look at this graph, we said it was going to the left this way forever towards negative infinity. When I look to the right of my graph, the arrow on the other side, we said it was going right forever to positive infinity. So that's our domain from negative infinity to infinity. That means that all of the x values, I can include any number in them. For the range, it's a little bit different because I have a very lowest value on my graph. It appears that this spot right here, that's the lowest that my graph gets. The range deals with y values. Okay? Deals with y values, and we're going to look at these from bottom to top. So I have a bottom of my graph this time. That lowest y value is at -2.25. That's the lowest y. But then my graph goes up and up and up and up forever because of those arrows. Going up forever means you have a range from -2.25 to infinity. The graph goes up forever. Now the last question here is asking about the axis of symmetry. We want to know, does this graph have an imaginary line that it can fold over? That would be yes. I kind of drew it in already here. Right down the middle, this graph has a line that it looks symmetric over. All right, that was kind of a tough example, but that's okay. We're going to keep working here. So let's look at example two. We're going to find the key features of this graph. First of all, is this graph a function? Well, yes, it passes the vertical line test again. So I know I can use it because it's a function. Now it says the graph is decreasing between what two values? Okay, well, when I look to the left, remember there's an arrow again, and the arrow going to the left means that my graph goes to the left forever, which means it's going to the left from negative infinity, and it's decreasing, decreasing, decreasing. Oh, look, there's another arrow. That means my graph goes forever again to infinity. Arrows imply infinity. Okay, so this graph is increasing everywhere, from negative numbers all the way through every positive number you can imagine. But it says, where is the graph increasing? Well, it appears to be increasing nowhere. The graph is increasing nowhere because it never goes up from left to right. This time, I now want to find the x-intercepts. Well, the x-intercept is where you cross the x-axis. That appears to be at -2, 0. Next, I want to find the y-intercept. So I'm trying to find the point where I cross the y-axis, which appears to be right down here at 0, -6. Okay, those are easy features of graphs. Now let's evaluate a point on the graph. We're trying to find g(0). Well, again, 0 is an x value when it's in the parentheses. So I go to where x is 0. I use a different color. I'm going to go down to the graph here until I get an output. At x(0), it appears that my output is negative 6. So the ordered pair that represents g of 0 is 0, negative 6. Now I added a different question this time. It says, find x for which g of x equals 1. That means you have a y value of 1 this time. So I'm going to go to my graph and I'm going to draw in the line for y equals 1. There appears to be only one point where the graph crosses that line y equals 1. And it appears to be right here at negative 3, 1. Well, the x value of that point is negative 3. Excuse me, and the ordered pair that gives me an output of 1 is negative 3, comma 1. Okay. The next thing I have is I want to find the maximum. Well, just like we talked about in the last example here, there's an arrow on the end of my graph. Now, that arrow doesn't look like it, but it's still going up. That graph is going up forever. So there's actually no maximum here again. There's also no minimum this time, because there's not a bottom. There's no lowest point on my graph. All right, and we get to the other two hardest. These last couple questions are the hardest ones of the day. Domain and range. Domain, again, deals from left to right with the x values. So when I look at the left, we just said my graph is going to the left forever. Forever to the left means it's going from negative infinity, and this graph is going down and to the right forever to positive infinity. Same idea here with the range this time. It is actually going up forever and down forever. So because my graph's going up and down forever, its range is also negative infinity to infinity. Hard concepts there. Now, axis of symmetry. Is my graph symmetric about a line? It doesn't look like it. There doesn't appear to be a place where I could fold the graph in half and it would look exactly the same. All right, two more examples here for us. Example 3. First of all, is this graph a function? Well, yes, it passes the vertical line test. Okay. Now we want to know, where is the graph decreasing? So my graph appears to be going down. Again, there's an arrow from negative infinity until this x value here of negative 1. Then once I get to negative 1, my graph appears to be increasing. So from negative 1, but then there's an arrow again over here, which means my graph goes up forever. Trying to find some x-intercepts of my graph, I need to find where we cross the axis. I paired across the x-axis at two places, and those ordered pairs appear to be negative 4, 0, and 2, 0, the points I darkened in. Now the y-intercept here is where I cross the y-axis. Here's the y-axis, and it happens to be at 0, negative 2. All right, let's do a little function notation here, then we'll talk about a little bit harder stuff on this set of questions. Evaluate g of negative 3. Negative 3 is in the parentheses, so it's an x value. So I go to where x is negative 3, and I go down to the graph. When I go down to the graph, it ends up giving me an output, the y value for that point of negative 1. So g of negative 3 equals negative 1, and the ordered pair that goes with it is negative 3 to negative 1. Now this time I'm trying to find an x value for which g of x equals negative 2. Excuse me. That negative 2 is a y value. So I'm going to go to where y equals negative 2 right here. Excuse me again. Got a cold here, though, I guess. Now it appears this time that I cross y equals negative 2 twice. So that x value for the first one looks to be at negative 2, which gives me an output of negative 2. And the other x value appears to be at 0. So negative 2 and 0 this time. So these ordered pairs are negative 2, negative 2, and 0, negative 2. Okay. Last couple questions for this example. All right, so now I need to find some maximums and minimums. All right, as with a couple other problems, my graph has arrows on the end. And those arrows imply that the graph is going up forever. Because it's going up forever, there is no maximum value. Because my graph is going up with the arrows. Now for a minimum, I'm looking for a very lowest point, which this graph appears to have. It has a lowest point. That lowest point appears to be at negative 1, negative 3. All right, now our favorite, domain and range. Domain, as we've been saying, goes from left to right. So I need to follow the graph as far to the left as it goes. Now this graph on the left has an arrow. The arrow means that it goes from negative infinity. All the way, the graph is going from negative infinity, then it comes onto our view, but then it goes on forever to positive infinity. Now I have a range. The range is always bottom to top, B to T. I want to decide, do I have a lowest point on this graph? Well, it turns out that I do. My graph doesn't get any lower than this minimum. The y value, because it says the range deals with y's, that this graph has is at negative 3. That's the lowest y value on this graph. Then it appears to go up with the arrows forever to infinity. Now, I actually just accidentally drew this line. That blue line I just drew down the middle does appear to be the axis of symmetry on a graph. I could fold that graph right in half. All right, to finish up, we have one more example here, and then we'll do lots and lots of practice. All right, find the key features of the graph f of x given below. First of all, I want to know, is this graph a function? Well, yes, it passes the vertical line test once again. So yes, I have a function. Where is the graph decreasing? Well, when I look at this graph, it appears to be decreasing everywhere. From the left, where there's an arrow, which means negative infinity, to the right, where there's another arrow. The graph is never increasing, because it's always going down. It is never going up from left to right. Now let's talk about x-intercepts, where I cross the x-axis. I appear to cross the x-axis right here at 2, 0. And I appear to cross the y-axis at the point 0, 4. Okay. Those are the easy ones, and now I have the function notation, which we should be getting really good at. F of 4, that 4 is an x value. So I go to where the graph is, has an x value 4, and I go all the way down till I get a point. That x value of 4, when I go down, looks like it gives me a y value of negative 4. So writing that as an ordered pair like I did on the graph, I have the point 4, negative 4. Now I want to find for which x value does f of x equal 6. We know now that that 6 is a y value. So I'm going to go to my graph, and I'm going to draw a y line at y equals 6. Okay. Now y equals 6, there appears to be one spot where the graph crosses that line. That x value is negative 1 right there. Notice it right there. So the ordered pair, I put the x first, negative 1, 6. That's the point that I cross. All right, maximums and minimums. When I look at my graph over here, it appears that there's an arrow again on the end. So my graph goes up forever. So it actually has no maximum, but it also goes down forever. So it also has no minimum. All right, last one here. Domain and range. My domain goes from left to right. Been talking about this in every problem, so hopefully you're starting to understand infinity here. Because my graph is going up and left forever, the domain starts at negative infinity. It's going left to negative infinity. My graph is also going to the right, that's this blank, to positive infinity. My range is the same idea. Range, the first blank is your top. It's going up an arrow to infinity. Oh, I'm sorry, I did that backwards. We do bottom to top. All right, so I look at the bottom first. I'm going down to negative infinity. And the top is going up to positive infinity. Okay? Domain and range are a really tough concept, but the more you practice it, the better you'll be. Finally, the axis of symmetry does not seem to be a place where there's a line where I could draw to cut that graph in half. Now, this is the toughest lesson of the unit, so you really should try to do the practice. There'll be a video for a few problems on the practice, and as always, come in for help for office hours if you need it.